Friends, today's topic of discussion is health and diseases. What you consider to be health and how you get your attack of diseases. First, we should understand what is health. Health has been defined by World Health Organization as wellness of mental, physical, and social well-being. So, we should be physically fit, mentally alert, and socially well-off. Now, how we can be like this? It means we should have body and mind and energy, all the three are in balance. Basically, energy should be in balance, because if we are having energy, we will have sharper mind, we will be confident, we will be happy, and we will have increased muscles. So, we feel energetic. So basically, what is important? The intensity of energy. Now, how it can happen? Let us understand. From where we get the energy, life energy. The life energy comes from two things. One is cosmic energy and another is food. We are from cosmic environment, we take prana, and it means we are taking oxygen as well as we are getting the consciousness from the cosmic energy. And also we are taking diet. And this food which we have taken as a diet, that gets energized, that is converted to energy only with the help of oxygen which we have taken from the cosmic environment. Now, for the time being, let us understand how we will remain energetic. Just see, we are having various homeostatic mechanisms that keep us internally well at the balance point. So whatever may be changes in the environment, if our internal system remain at the within a tolerable limit, then we are happy and healthy. So, how this homeostatic mechanism is balanced, let us understand. There are three mechanisms. One is nervous system, another is immunity system, and last is endocrine system. Basically, these three are responsible to maintain the environment and keep the internal system within tolerable limit, even if there is a change in external environment. How it is done? These systems detect and oppose the changes that happens because of external environment. It means there should be a feedback loops that detect that there is change, and these systems, they oppose, they start opposing the changes. For that, what are there in this mechanism? There are neurons in the nervous system, neurotransmitters and hormones in the endocrine system. But how they work? Actually, we are having body chemicals in the form of blood and lymphs. So if our blood and lymphs, they are working properly, it means our cardiovascular system and lymphatic systems are working properly, then body chemicals can work and they can be balanced by the neurons, by the hormones. So there are homeostatic receptors in each and every glands and organs everywhere that is responsible for having the balance. This neuro, and also there are cytokines. This is created by the immune system. So these, they balance the body cells. Because if our cardiovascular system or lymphatic system are not properly working, then there will be no homeostasis, because these neurotransmitter, hormones, cytokines, they work through the body chemical. So body chemical balance must be there. Whenever we are hurt, whether mentally or physically, immediately our autonomic system works. The sympathetic system will immediately react. Suppose we get hurt physically, then we'll feel pain. That is the reaction of sympathetic nervous system. But after some time, pain becomes less. This parasympathetic nerves make the things calm down. And we start working with the digestion rest. We are getting the rest. So we must understand that two things are responsible. First thing is cardiovascular system or lymphatic system. Second thing is that homeostatic mechanism through the neurotransmitter, hormones and cytokine, this immunity system that works properly, then we will be happy, we will be healthy. Now, as we are discussing that the cosmic energy and food, they react with each other. We are getting the oxygen. When we are getting the oxygen, it means our food is getting oxidized during the digestion, or we can say the ATP synthesization in mitochondria can become only with the help of oxygen. So ATP gets converted into energy in the oxidation. But during the oxidation process, one negative thing is that oxygen radicals, rather we can say this oxygen ions, they are get released in the system. So as per free radical theory, these radicals, they destroy the cells. When they destroy the cells, so it means there is a failure of antioxidant, because our body have antioxidant mechanism that prevents this failure due to oxygen ions. So the failure of antioxidants, what it creates? It creates inflammation. And everybody know what is the inflammation? If it is on the skin, if we are feeling that the skin has become hot, there is some redness has come, or there is swelling. So this is the visible example of inflammation. As it is on the physical body, you are seeing this similarly, the oxidative stress can come our with the psychosocial problems also. If we are getting mentally hurt, we'll get the oxidative stress and inflammation may be there. And when it happens, what will happen? It will change the gut microbiota. We all know that in our guts, there's so many bacteria and other microbes are there. So if there is oxidative stress, it means we are tense, we are having a stress, we are feeling pain. At that time, the gut microbiota will change and we will feel disease. So first thing, the oxidation may cause disease. Inflammation may cause disease. Though inflammation is the protection system, if it is for the shorter period, inflammation is provided to safeguard, to heal our body. But if it is prolonged for a longer period, that it can be dangerous. It can be a cause for disease. And what is the third thing? That is toxicity. We know whether we have taken food from the plants or we have taken from the animal food, everything has the antigenic poison. This antigenic poison is provided by the nature in the plant as well as in the body of the animals. So that can be toxic also, though to some extent they are providing the antioxidants. So if toxicity is more, oxidation, due to oxidation, if radicals are there and failure of antioxidant mechanism that provide the inflammation, then this will be the cause for aging and stress. It means for health, two things are responsible. One is homeostasis and aging. What do you understand by aging? That if your system becomes old, and rather you looks older if you are aging. So because of the aging and stress, you may lose confidence. You may feel sick. Your bone may get osteoporosis. Plaques are deposited in your cardiovascular system. This type of things may be there. So now we have understood the health and disease. Now, let us understand what is disease. Because if our body is disease-free, we feel healthy. So, what is the disease? Disease is pathophysiological response to various external and internal factors. Otherwise, we are healthy. If we are no disease, it means there is no adverse response of the factors and we remain stable, calm and quiet, then we are disease-free, we are healthy, we are happy. So why it happens? We all know that we are getting energy from the cosmic environment and food. And oxidation of food takes place. That is why free radicals are there, that we have already discussed. Let us see how these factors affect our health. If there is a positive and social environment, it means we are having good companions. We love each other. Good friends, younger friends, love each other. And there is no atmosphere of hatred or anger, anything. Then that will be conducive for the health. And what will happen? That our aging will decrease because oxidative stress will be less and we'll feel younger, healthy, happy. Or at the same time, if there is a negative social environment, then because microbiota of the guts have changed, then we'll feel older because our aging has increased. So you must be saying that some people looks younger as compared to the age, or some people looks older as compared to the age. So these factors. So the first factor is social environment that is more responsible to make us, to keep us younger, healthy, or as a sick people, and we are getting older because aging starts taking place. Second thing, if we are taking the good diet means we have calorific restrictions. We are taking the nutrients, proper nutrients, not extra. Then our aging will decrease and you will feel younger. And against this, if we are taking high fat diets, we become obese, obesity is there, then our aging will increase. So some people who are taking the fatty diets, luxurious diets, then they get older earlier. Third thing, the third thing is if we are doing moderate exercise, not extensive exercise, and yoga, pranayama, meditation, then our aging will decrease and we will feel younger. And against this, if you are having sedentary lifestyle or we are overstressing, overexerting, then our aging will be more and we will look older. The last thing here we want to discuss is that if we are having selfless action, it means we are not having selfish pursuit. If we are helping others without desiring any gain, any fruits from that, my action, that is, you are doing a selfless action, then you will remain healthy. You are helping others, you are donating the things. So in that way, you will feel happy and your aging will decrease, you will look younger. At the same time, if you are having selfish pursuit, everything you are remain calculating that we should do this thing, we should not do that thing, here we will get advantage, there I will not get, that you will. Then your aging will increase and then you will look older. So, but what happens with all this? Either you will have stress-related disorders. See, you may have back pain, you may have blood pressure, diabetes, or there can be anxiety-related disorder because of the environment, negative environment. Yeah. If it becomes excessive, then there will be panic attack. You will worry it. And anxiety become excessive, then you become, there will be panic attack. घबराहट हो जाएगी आपको बहुत ज्यादा बार बार हर चीज में घबराने लगो Similarly, there can be psychosomatic disorder. What is this psychosomatic disorder? If you are having some ailments from the beginning, initially it is there, so that will aggravate. Let's say, for example, emotional trauma could lead to an asthma attack. Or stress could lead to migraine or chest pain. So what should we do? We should try to have the positive social environment, taking restricted caloric food with proper nutrients, and we should do some moderate exercise, do yoga, pranayama, meditation, and do selfless action. We should not be selfish. We should try to do to help others, and whatever work we do, there also we should be selfless. Then we'll feel healthy. Friends, if you like this video, please subscribe it and put the like button also, so that it motivates us to prepare some more videos like this. Thank you.